Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you a project that can convert these Palm Portable PDA keyboards into Bluetooth keyboards that can pair with your tablet, phone, or laptops. Now this Palm keyboard, they were released 20 years ago for Palm PDAs. As you can see, when they are folded, they are quite small. And you can unfold it like this. It's a very cool mechanism. And when it is unfolded, the size is actually larger than modern laptop keyboards, and it's very comfortable to type on. These keyboards, you can find them pretty cheap on eBay for like a little more than $10. Unfortunately, these cannot be directly used on modern devices because the connector is a Palm PDA only. So I made an adapter that can interface with this connector and translate into Bluetooth, and you can use it with your Bluetooth devices. Now, if you are interested in buying one of these keyboards, keep in mind there are several versions, and this one is for Palm 5. The connector is different from this one, so this one is a Palm 3. As you can see, the connector is slightly different. My project only works with these two. You would need to print a different socket for this part, but all the other circuits and the software, they are the same. So let me show you how this works. It's actually pretty simple. You just put it on the connector, and you are already paired with, in this case, it's already paired with iPad. You can just start typing. As you can see, all the keys are correctly mapped, and I have even mapped some combination keys, like increasing or decreasing the brightness and the volume and home button, things like that. So yeah, it's pretty simple. Just plug and play. Now if you are done typing, you can just remove this and fold it back into place. You are ready to go. Now let's take a closer look at this adapter. So in here, this connector to the keyboard, I have put a tiny switch within it. So when you insert the connector, it connects the battery and automatically powers on. When you remove that adapter, the power would be automatically disconnected. So it's a very convenient thing. You don't need to worry about the battery drains. And these two buttons are a reset button and pair button. You can use that to clear the pairing state of this adapter. You have a micro USB charging port, and also you can update firmware with that. Let me show you the internal of this adapter. So there are four screws. You just need to remove those. And now you can separate them into two parts. So this is a main assembly. As you can see, the internal of this thing is pretty simple. The main board is an off-the-shelf product from Adafruit. It is a NRF52-based development board. We just need to solder some transistors and resistors and do some 3D printing, and we can make this. I have uploaded the DIY process and the firmware code onto GitHub. You can check the link in the video description. Now, I made this adapter mostly for the upcoming Steam Deck that I'm trying to purchase because that does not have a keyboard built in or officially released with. But this works with any laptops and other devices, and it actually have a cool feature that it has a phone support hidden underneath it. So if you are trying to type on a phone, you can put that nicely on the support. I have already paired the phone with the keyboard, so you can put it like this or horizontally and type something. It works really well. One weird behavior of this keyboard or with this adapter is that on some devices it actually shows a delay that I'm not sure where this comes from. So if anybody watching this knows more about Bluetooth than I do, please leave a comment. Let me show you the quirkiness. So this is a OnePlus 5T. This quirkiness happens on just two of my 10 devices, so I'm not sure if it's a software thing or a hardware incompatible thing. But if you type it on this OnePlus, you can see there's a significant delay, but when you just press one key, it shows up pretty fast. It just happens when you press many keys. It seems like there's a latency between each key that eventually accumulates. So I don't know where this behavior comes from. If you know, please tell me. Thanks. So yeah, this is the adapter I made. Feel free to make one, and I think it's actually pretty useful and pretty cool to play with. Thank you.